Hey, it's Mikey, and today we're talking about the fast-firing assault rifle, the FFAR, aka the FAMAS from Black Ops. Just some easy tips that you can use to get dark matter easily. Should be able to get this done within a day. Let's just get into it. So the first challenge you're going to have is the Policia camo, where you get 100 headshots with the FFAR. Disclaimer, these are just my suggestions. What has worked best for me? You can mix, match, do whatever you like. All right, guys, this isn't like the end all be all. So for the attachments, quick draw and stock. Quick draw lets you aim faster, obviously, and stock allows you taking a position. Love these attachments for headshots. For the perks, we want ghost. We'll be doing lots of flanking around, and you gotta be stealthy if you want to sneak up on someone, get that headshot. If you're not very accurate, you know, I don't have the best accuracy, that is where stalking, creeping up on people, it helps you out. You flank around them and you can take your time. So ghost allows you that privilege just to be a little bit more sneakier. Along those lines, we got fast hands, so that way after we get done sprinting, pull up the gun even faster. And you gotta have hardwired, whether you're playing core or hardcore. In core, it's gonna keep people from seeing you with their sixth sense perk. You know, you won't be able to sneak up on them. You must have that. And even if it's something like hardcore where there's no mini map up, you don't want to set off a trip mine or a shock charge and, you know, get stunned and have it ruin your day. So to me, those three are a must. Ghost, fast hands, hardwired. And I like awareness and dead silence, so that way we can not only sneak up on people quietly, but we can hear them wherever they're at. All right, for the specialists, I really think there is no better choice than Firebreak. He literally freezes people. Although it's not really freezing, he stuns them. He stuns people, they're stuck there, and you can get possibly one or two easy headshots depending on how many people you stunned. For the score streaks throughout this thing, for the most part, except for maybe one or two of the challenges, UAV, counter UAV, that's it. It allows you to focus on your challenge. You can spam these things out. They launch quick. You know, it's not like a sentry gun or something where you mess with it. This is built around completing this challenge very quickly, okay? You don't have the pressure of going for a mothership or some high streak. That allows you to focus. Be focused, stay focused, quit wasting your time on other stuff. Love this setup, UAV, counter UAV. And a nice side effect is when you're spamming all these things, well, one, you're helping out your team so they can get UAVs, but you can catch people who are shooting, trying to shoot down your UAVs, or at the very least, they're giving away their position. So that's a really nice side effect of that. I do like domination, or even better, hardcore domination, where I pretty much settled in, because with the FFAR, it's got a lot of recoil, and in hardcore, it's basically one or two shots to the head, and that's it. So I prefer hardcore, but you can do whatever you like. Not to mention in domination, the spawns are slightly more predictable, and you have a general idea where people are gonna be at. Let's move on to the next challenge, Ardent. This one's super easy. You only need 10 of these medals. Get 10 long shots with the FAMAS. I'm gonna just call it the FAMAS from here on out, guys. Super easy, just hop into hardcore domination, find a spot to overlook the B flag, and that's pretty much it. You can use any class really, but here's a class that I use to speed things up. Thermal really helps you see through smoke. It actually helped me get quite a few kills this way. We can spot people a little bit easier. Stock, gotta have that because you're pretty much gonna be aiming down your sights a lot. Stock lets you duck in and out a little bit easier. Grip is going to help with that recoil, and since you're pretty much going to be like a camper, extended mag can help out a lot too. All right, and for the perks, I have blind eye, cold-blooded, and awareness. Awareness is to keep people from sneaking up on me for the most part, and I just have the blind eye and the cold-blooded to prevent people from using their streaks on me, and in case they have a thermal, I won't pop up as easily to them. All right, so just camp it out, and it should only take you one or two games. All you need is 10 of them. All right, the next challenge is a burnt. Get 50 kills with the FAMAS without any attachments, but we're going to save that for a little bit later on, okay? So we will get back to this. Bliss. Get 50 kills with the FAMAS with an optic and 5 attachments equipped. So really, use whatever you like with any sight you want, but the setup that I found pretty fun was Elo sight, just a personal preference, stock, grip, extended mag, rapid fire, and high caliber. And for this, I specifically wanted to play close quarters just to get it over with and Nuketown. Or if Nuketown is not available when you're watching this, you can just play Mosh Pit. Nuketown pops up a lot. People almost always vote for it. So the main problem with this challenge and going for this challenge on this map is you can't use Tac Mask. All your points are being spent on attachments, and if you're on Nuketown, you already know you may get flashed, you may get stunned. It depends on the lobby. Okay, sometimes people don't use that stuff. But if you do end up in a lobby where there's throwing stuns and flashes like crazy, have a backup class. What's that backup class? It is gonna be for Burnt. Get 50 kills with the FAMAS without any attachments. So you will have two classes, the one with all the attachments and one that's completely perked out. And obviously you definitely want to have Tac Mask on there. You can have Ready Up, Flak Jacket. You can do pretty much whatever you like. Now, the other reason why I skipped the Burnt Camo Challenge a little bit earlier was usually I like to save it for the very, very end, the very last challenge, once all the other challenges are done, so that way you can prestige the weapon. When you prestige a weapon, you lose all its attachments, but you unlock the kill counter or clan tag, and you have a chance to earn more XP if you're on your road to level 1000. Okay, so I like to save that for the very, very end if possible. So Nuketown is great for 5 attachments or no attachments, since you're going to have more kills than usual. You know where people are at. All right, so now we got 2 more left. We have Battle. Get 2 rapid kills 5 times with both kills coming from the FAMAS. That's super easy. Easy on Nuketown. It's just going to happen on its own. Nothing special here. And Chameleon. Get 5 Bloodthirsties. So really, depending on the type of player you are, this could be easy or it could be hard. I mean, I'm just an average player, so it really wasn't that big a deal for me. But I will give you guys a Bloodthirsty class suggestion, and this is mainly aimed for Nuketown. Okay, so the big thing is having the gun at the ready. So we're gonna build a class built around having our gun quick and just being ready for the most part. So for the attachments, quick draw, obviously grip, gonna help a lot because this gun's got a lot of recoil. For the perks, it really doesn't make any sense to have ghosts, since on Nuketown, everyone knows where each other's at pretty much. We don't have a silencer. Who cares? So we got overclock, so that way we can get our fire break faster. And I'm sorry, heat wave. And heat wave on Nuketown, you know, you have the chance to stun 2 guys, 3 guys maybe. So overclock and heat wave, they go hand in hand. It's great. Got Ready Up. You definitely need that on Nuketown. You're gonna bump into people constantly. Hardwired is really just because people tend to throw trip mines and shock charges indoors. Awareness is great. It really does help on Nuketown if you got a headset. And standard issue, gotta have Tac Mask. All right, so you can just like troll them, run around in their house, hang around the middle area. But really, I mean, getting 5 kills on Nuketown, it should be relatively easy for you guys. For the streaks, UAV, counter, and Guardian. Guardian can actually help you get some kills. Just, I like to place it in the middle of the map. You can place it to the side, wherever you like. High traffic area. Okay, high traffic area, so that way you can definitely catch someone, freeze them there. All right, guys, so like I said, you should be able to do this within a day. It really isn't that tough. If you want to come out to the open lobbies, as usual, I stream each weekend, Twitter, Facebook. That's where I post when I do that, the contests, giveaways, and things. Links to that stuff down below. Please take 3 seconds to rate the video. I'll see you next time. Hey, did you know I have a second channel? Yep, that is where I do the Let's Plays, walkthroughs, rant, all kinds of random stuff. So you can click on the screen, links down below to the Let's Play channel. And on the right side, full playlist of Black Ops 3 tips, tricks, info. I keep that updated for you. You can click on the screen or links down below.